We are going to start things off looking at the Logitech G Hub. Here we can see, got my mouse plugged in. I select the mouse I want to activate. And here we have DPI settings. So you could set your points for DPI all along this bar. You could drag, drop wherever you need. You've got your defaults here. You can assign to a mouse. And then you have report rate per response. I have it set at 1000 right now. You can also select restore default settings for everything with the mouse. We're going to come over here to assignment because this is where you're going to be able to actually assign a option for all of the six mouse buttons. Obviously, you would select the mouse button that you want to do, and then you can come in here and you can select from a whole bunch of presets as to what that mouse button will do. You also have options for key binding and actions. Here you'll notice that it is accessible with Overwolf, Discord, and OBS, which is awesome. We also have the ability to create macros. So if you need to create macros for your MMORPG, here's how you can set up a new macro. Type the name of the macro. We're not going to go through that. Just know that you can create macros using this mouse. System, again, here we go. Lots of options for us for assigning system controls to the mouse. Moving along to the LightSync, because this is definitely what you're here for. This is why you bought this instead of the Prodigy. We've got our presets. We have lots of different effects. So we can turn this off. We can cycle, or we can fix. So fix means you will, and this is exactly what it looks like on the mouse as I'm using it. Fix is a solid state color. You can change that color as you wish. So if we wanted to make that red, there you go. Now it's fixed at red. Selecting cycle is what you were watching while I was filming. It's going to cycle through all the possible colors. You have your rate change and your brightness. Breathing, again, you could specify your color and it will do exactly what it's doing here. You'll have that fade in and fade out effect. Color wave, well, here we go. It's going to do a horizontal, in this case, color wave. We can do a reverse horizontal, but you'll notice that it's going to shift from left to right, color waving. Color blend, here you go. Blending of the colors. So blue to purples, reds to pinks. You get the idea. Moving on. Audio visualer, so this is going to be listening to your computer to match the sound that it hears, playing music, video games, things like that, and have your mouse visualize those sounds. You have your advanced settings here. I won't go through these, but just know that's what it's at. I'm going to go back to cycle just so we have something to look at. You've got your option for freestyle, so you have effect. You can add a new effect. Here you can obviously see we could change the color of the effects, and here you've got your particular lighting zones that you can set. So I want to have hypothetically a red effect here. On this one here, I want more of a green effect there. And then over on this one, we will set a yellow-ish. So there we go. You can see that is a particular lighting effect. On the screen, it doesn't look as good, but I promise the effect on the mouse itself, I'll insert a picture of actually what that looks like. And I will say, hopefully the picture does it justice, because it actually is kind of a cool effect. You also have your ability for animations. You've got, here we go, this is the first time I popped over into this one, ocean wave, red, white, and blue. So again, what you see on screen is exactly what the mouse is doing. And then you can cycle, random bounce, all that. I think you get the idea of what you can do with the color effects here. Now, if you wanted to move to the onboard memory instead of using the G Hub, what you have to do is come up to the upper left-hand corner, select the sprocket, and then you select onboard memory on, and then this device will turn to onboard memory. We now move over to the next piece of software, which is the onboard memory. From here, you can see this is the mouse we currently have selected. We've got profile one. We have our DPI set points. We actually have an extra one right there. We could see our refresh rate. We could see the light is cycling. On this particular screen, you can't see that, but if we wanted to, we can select off and then hit save. And what that will do is no longer will the mouse cycle through. That's actually how my wife prefers it. We have our button assignments here. When you are using your onboard memory, you cannot change left click and right click, but you can change every other mouse button. So here you go. You've got drop down options for each and every one of those, which is great. And then you can also select identify button, which means if I press it, it will tell you exactly what button it is. You can also enable default or change it to G shift, which will pretty much blank everything out and let you change everything. I recommend default because you kind of need that left click and right click. But that has been the Logitech G Hub and the onboard memory controls for the Logitech G203 LIGHTSYNC.